Here is another teardown video. What is in the suitcase?
The case is from California.
I suspect the constant content here is really, really smelly because I had a little sneaky peek. Ooh, it is the other way. Come on, man. This thing is just huge. Look at the size of that thing. You. That is some sticky gross. Oy. There's clearly some, looks a little really military. Oh, this is gross as heck. Huh? North? Can you see this? North and a little arrow? This one is heavy. Some wires and some screw. Oh, this is, there's a more of them. Ooh, look at that. A tripod of some, yeah. Oh, I gotta get the vacuum cleaner, but this looks like a tripod screw together thingy. Oh man, this is so gross. What is this for? Oh, this is a carrying belt. You see? You can take this on. So you can... And there's a... This is a, probably a bag for the sensor. Yikes. And a whole bag of batteries. Ooh. Why are they in this box? So, and just to try and imagine this smell, I can't even breathe. It's gonna go in the garden in a second. So there's a connector here for the sensor that sticks in this one, and maybe this... Okay, I need to throw something out and clean up and then get back. See ya! I cleaned up everything and thrown out the box. I find out that this is not a tripod, but this is an ultra fast to retract stick. You just fold it and then impossible to do with one hand, and then stick them together, and then you... Oh, it looks like there's a thread in here, see? Then they go in here. Oh. Anyway, the thing is, that is probably not important. But what I found out is the end of this thing. Of course, that one fits in the big, big sensor. Ah, that camera sucks. See? This is how it screws directly onto the sensor, so you can go and lift around with this and do some sample this and that, and... I don't know, what can you measure with this? Maybe something magnetic, because see? Plus and minus, and they are marked, so that is important. And look at that screw. What else I found? Listen to this. It's full of a liquid. Maybe it's water. Or maybe it's piss, I don't know. So, this is the fantastic box. Geometrix. Magnetometer. G816. So this is the signal and battery. Aha, battery. Read what? Ah! Clickety clickety. And then tuning kilo gammas. Gammas. Yamas. That is how much whatever magneto funky stuff. So the sensor. I think it's just, what do we do? Ah! Easy. And then what? Okay, we're in. Okay, this explains the batteries. Go up. Look at that. Ooh. Ay, ay, ay. This is... Oh, this smell is intense. Weak. Oh, what the hell? Where's the dead rat? Okay. Oh, what the hell? What is that? A map of the world. So if you're getting lost, you can use this map and this sensor and you will find your way to the nearest pizza joint. Oi, that is what it can do. The total intensity of the Earth magnetic field. Expressed in kilo something. What I have to... We have to go. So 50. We are between 45 and 50. I'm totally going in the garden tomorrow. What happens when we boot this stinker up? Oh, says some more here. 18 volts, half an amp. Serial number is 777. Ooh, I thought it was something else more appropriate. Because this one definitely smelled like a something bad happened to it. I can't wait to see what's in here. And there's the... Something is dead in here. I have to go and breathe. Alright, I put the sensor on the unit. Put in the batteries. Push the button and... It measures some... And if I do it again, it measures more or less the same value. So something is clearly going on. It's like, oh, now it became really, really heavy. Look at that. Don't you just love a product that needs, I don't know, half a ton of batteries? Oh my God. Can you imagine how expensive this is to fill this up? And they were all 1.5 volts in the plastic bags. Are they all brand new, the batteries? Wow. That's actually great. Now I'm really sad that I don't have anything to use those batteries for. But that was a pretty good score. I actually got the manual because it's easy to get the manual online. I've been reading a little bit about this and they don't explain exactly what the hell it measures and how you do it and whatever you do and what is it this good for. It sounds like it's measuring a lot of bogus. So, I don't really get the idea of what you... If you just crank this up, it just measures some more. So, what the hell are you reading? I have no clue how to operate this, and the manual didn't really make me more clever. It made me more confused. You see? It's just like, you get some funky numbers here. I don't know. I think we need to go outside and measure some stuff.
So now we're outside in the garden. We're gonna try and see what this thing is all about. I found out about this north. Where the heck is that marking? There's supposed to be a north marking here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this up in the air all the way like this. This is the height.
Whoa.
And I'm really gonna hold this. And then we're going to try and push the button and see the number. Then, so that was 48. And then I'll try and do the same again without moving anything. Okay, so it's 50. So now I move it 45 degrees to the left. Let's see if it's sensitive to rotation. 50. So I move it to 45 again. And then see what happens. 40, aha! And then 45 more. 50. I think actually we're back now, right? So the thing is 48. So it is generating some numbers. It's actually pretty cool. I have no idea really what it's measuring.
There's some magnetic fantastic things.
All right. Now I'm inside. I took off the cover. Just two screws in each side. Super, super easy. Oh, look, there's like a battery leak went all the way through the casing. Whoa. So it's really, really old. But how old is this? I don't really know. But what I see is like 73 on a lot of the parts. See again, 73. And it just continues with 73. Even on the capacitor, see, they start with 73. And you can just, it goes on and on and on with this 73 stuff on all the different ICs. No, not on that one. So how old is this baby? Look at that. Oh, a crystal, 1.4 megahertz, and then a number, serial number 19 on the crystal. Maybe there's a number on the crystal. No. But what I found, look at all the display drivers and transistors and whatnot. Maybe those are counters, and those will be the drivers, or seven segment decoding and something like that. So this is the G818. But look at the displays. They're called CM5-11-0958. Maybe that is the date codes, or 88. No, it's not. No idea. But look, how sexy is that? And again, 73 on the connector. Look at the displays. Even the dots. Little tiny bulbs. Isn't that just cute? And how if we try and turn, oh, see if I can, yeah, click. Let's have a look. Oh, look at that. And the bottom side of the PCB, just beautiful. Look how shiny it is. This is also a really, really thick layer of conformal coating. They don't want any problems with this. So when you make stuff right, it just lasts forever. That is just how it is. So I just wonder, can I use this for anything at all? Is it maybe worth anything to anybody. I haven't really figured out what you can use the measurements for. I think it's more like a collector's item or something like that. And here we got a lot of capacitors. So all those two sets of wires, that will be some timing. A lot of different values of capacitors. And all this goes via a shielded braid all the way up to this switch. So this is the switch where you set all sorts of magic things. Yeah. It's really cute.